Hello everyone, I hope you guys are doing well. I'm Shubham and you're watching Let's Create an App. So in this video, we are going to talk about how we can create an image viewer. Basically, in an image viewer, we can view the image as well as we can zoom the image according to our need. We can see the tiny small things in the image viewer by zooming the image. So first, let's see the demo and then we will see how we can create this kind of functionality. So this is the demo app which we are going to create today. And in this, just press the Alt key to zoom this thing. And as I'm trying to zoom this thing, this will completely zooming. And this is an image view with content mode is aspect fit. So basically, this is complete as an image view. So this is not showing any kind of black spacing when I'm trying to zoom. So we will see all these things in this video, that how we can manage this thing, how we can avoid the extra spacing coming in the image. We have to remove this thing. So how we can do this thing, we are going to see this thing in this video. This functionality is very easy to create, so let's look how we can create this kind of functionality. And if you like this video, please don't forget to hit the like button. And if you're new to the channel, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon to get the notifications of all my other videos. So let's start the video. Let's create an app. So open an Xcode, click on single view application and click on next. Give the name whatever you want to give. I'm just giving image viewer like this, and click on next and save this project where you want to save. I'm just saving this project on desktop. So now application is created and saved on the desktop. Now first we have to move on the storyboard. So just click on this main.storyboard. Now we have to take one scroll view. So just take a scroll view, because we have to make this functionality by using scroll view. And really this is very easy functionality if you have a basic knowledge of how scroll view works. So that's really very easy. Now just take one image view which can be placed in this scroll view. So simply like image view, and place this image view in this scroll view. So give all the four sides 0 to this image view. So as we know, the subviews of the scroll view always required equal width and equal height, or we have to specify the specific height of a subview in scroll view. So for that, we have to give two more constraints to this image view, and that are equal width and equal height. So like this. So the constraints are satisfying. There is no red mark over here. Now we have to assign one image to this image view. So for that, we have to move on the asserts. And now we have to get one image. So I've already downloaded an image. So this is a Kung Fu Panda movie 3 movie image, and this is one of my favorite movie. I hope you guys also like this movie. And now we have to place this image over here, so like this. So now the image content mode is right now scale to fill, so it's totally up to you what content mode you are giving to this image view. Now I'm just changing content mode to aspect fit, so this will automatically make my image with respect to the aspect ratio of the actual image. So by doing this, we will get this thing. Now we have to give a black color to the back view like this. Now let's run this thing and check that it is working fine or not. So let's run and check. So basically, scroll view is one of the powerful component or powerful element of iOS, because table view, contain collection view, all are containing scroll view. So we can also use this function, we can also create this kind of functionality by using collection view if we have multiple images. So we can directly provide scrolling functionality also with this zooming functionality. So the application is running now, and we are seeing this image. So but right now we are not able to zoom this image, because definitely we didn't provide any kind of delegate methods to this scroll view. So let's move on this controller like this. Take outlet for this image view first. Okay, so right now this image view, and just drag and drop and write image view like this. Connect. Now we have to provide delegate methods of scroll view. So before providing any delegate methods of scroll view, first we have to define the minimum scale and maximum scale of this image view with respect to scroll view. So yeah, we have to take the scroll view outlet first. So just take the scroll view outlet like this and connect this thing like this. Now we have to use the maximum and minimum zoom scale. So the maximum zoom scale is 4. You can change the how much zoom you want to make in the application and the minimum zoom scale. Be sure that minimum zoom scale will be 1 or greater than 1, because if you are not taking a less zoom scale, less than 1, then maybe some kind of spaces will be left in from both the sides of the image. So you can try this thing, and we will talk further in this scenario. Now we have to just implement the scroll view delegate methods. So let's create extension to define the delegate methods of this scroll view. So for that we have to write extension view controller, and this is a UI scroll view delegate, this one. So we have to implement first method, that is a view for zoom. I guess this is the delegate method. So let's type this thing and check that it is the same. Yeah, view for zooming, and this will returns a UI view, means any view which we wants to make zoom. So simply we have to return the image view over here, return image view like this. And one more thing, we have to assign a delegate also to this controller. So you can type over here scroll view dot delegate first to cell. You can also do this thing via storyboard, so it's totally up to you. Now let's run this thing and check that it is working fine or not. Then we will talk about what are the drawbacks of this functionality and how we can overcome from these drawbacks. So let's press Alt key and try to zoom this thing, and we are successfully able to zoom this thing. But as I zoom down, so it will left a space over at the top, definitely, because the image view is total and there is, these are the empty spaces which will be covered in this image. So in zooming, these spaces will definitely cover. So we have to remove these spaces when the user zoom. So we have to implement one complex logic. It will be simple, I will explain each and every line. So we have to implement one more delegate method of scroll view, and that is a view did zoom. So just like view did zoom, scroll view did zoom, this one. Now we have to create some conditions in this method so that we can get if the image is moving out from the width, and we have to manage the ratio of the image view. So for that, first we have to check the scroll view zoom scale is greater than 1 or not. So for that, if scroll view dot zoom scale is greater than 1 like this. Now we have to take the image from the image view. So if let image equals to image view dot image like this. So this is the image which is right now in this image view. So now we have to perform all the operations on this image. So for that, first we have to take the ratio of the image view. So let ratio width is equals to image view dot frames dot width, and this is divided by the image which we will get dot size dot width. Now we have to do the same thing with respect to the height. So ratio height equals to image view dot frame dot height divided by image dot size dot height. So by doing this thing, we will get the ratio of the width and height. Now we have to take one more ratio which will be greater from both with respect to width and height. So for that, type ratio equals to, now we have to put the conditions just like ratio of width, if this will be smaller than ratio of height. Ratio of height. Now if this will be condition is true, we have to take a ratio of width, else we have to take a ratio of height. So we have placed a ternary operator over here. If you don't know about the ternary operator, you guys go and check out what is ternary operator. We will get the maximum ratio in the ratio. Now we have to use this ratio to get the new height and new width of the image which is in the image view. So for that, we have to just write let new width is equals to, we have to multiply the width of actual image with respect to the ratio like this. So by doing this thing, we will get the new width. Similarly, we have to find the new height equals to image dot size dot height like this, and we have to multiply this thing with respect to ratio. Now we have to change the content inset of the scroll view. So for changing the content inset of the scroll view, we have to get the left and right as well as top and bottom content inset of the scroll view. So for that, first we have to get the left, and then we will get top. So for that, first I'm just placing a condition. So let condition width for left is equals to, so I'm just placing a condition over here, because the if I put this condition in the next statement, this will the statement will become very big and you guys get confused. So for that, I'm just placing over here. So just like new width into scroll view dot zoom scale, I guess zoom scale, correct, will be greater than the present width of the image view. So image view dot frame, sorry, image view dot frame dot width, like this. So this is the condition actually. Now we have to use this condition and get the new left or new width. So let left is equals to, we have to just place this condition left, and now we have to put the ternary operator. So for that, just put this question mark. Now we have to use new width minus image view dot frame dot width, like this. And if this condition is not satisfying, then we have to put the scroll view dot frame dot width minus scroll view dot content size dot width, like this. We have to put this thing in a bracket, so this will be a single statement, like this. And we have to do one more thing, that we have to put all these things in a bracket and multiply the complete statement with 0.5, like this. So by doing this thing, we will put a condition over here. So whatever it will return, like a true or false, this will come over here, or on the basis of it will choose that if the true will come, it will follow this condition, and if false, then this will follow this condition. So we have to do this thing over here. Now we have to do the same thing, condition top, like this. And we have to put this condition for height. So for simply like new height, like this, into scroll view dot zoom scale, and this will be greater than, we have to follow the same condition which we have used above, but only change that is height, like this. And we have to get the new top, that top is equals to, similarly condition top, and in this we have to use new height, and this will be minus image view dot frames dot height, like this. And this will like scroll view dot frame dot height, frame dot height minus scroll view dot content size dot height, like this. And we have to put this thing in a bracket, like this. So similarly, we have to place one more bracket over here and multiply this whole condition with 0.5. we are multiplying this condition with 0.5 because we always make the everything in center. So by entering 0.5, the everything will come in center. You can change the conditions over here to check that is it true or not. So now we have get all the things, the left as well as on the top. Now we have to put the content inset of the scroll view. So scroll view dot content inset, this one. And here we have to use a UI edge inset, this one. And in this we have to put the top. So the new top which we have left, the left which we find, and the bottom is always equal to the top, and right is always equal to the left. So like this, we have done all the things. So I think everything is fine. Now let's put the else condition over here. So if so there is no else condition for this, if image there is no image, then definitely nothing we have to do. If the zoom scale is not greater than 1, then we have to place the else condition, and in this we have to pass the scroll view dot content inset, and in this content inset we have to pass the 0 like this. So now let's run this thing and check that it is working fine or not, and just remove these empty spaces so the R code will look more easy. So let's zoom this thing, and so we are successfully zooming this thing, and if we are putting pulling down this thing, this is not pulling raw and it will automatically manage the left and right spaces. Now let's zoom more like this, and now let's put this thing a little bit down and it will automatically move at the top. So this is really cool, and we can also check this thing with the bottom also. So it's completely working fine. So you can create this kind of functionality by this code, and hope you like this video. And if you face any difficulty, please let me know in the comment section. And if you like this video, please don't forget to hit the like button. And if you're new to the channel, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon to get the notifications of all my other videos. If you have any query or suggestion, please post that thing in the comment section. So meet you in the next video. Thank you.